Hey guys, it's me. I'm back again with another update from the developers of Hell Let Loose. They've just released developer briefing number 175, and guys, it looks pretty hot. So last week we were given a glimpse of the brand new winter map Kharkov, as well as some new placeholder winter uniforms. But that's not all that's new with update 13. To help relieve that chill of the freezing cold Kharkov map, the developers have added the addition of flamethrowers and molotovs. Flamethrowers will not only set troops, but also the surrounding area on fire. Due to its power, the flamethrowers can only be used in a brace fire stance similar to the machine guns. These flame-dealing units will allow the user to wield their stream of flames for approximately 20 seconds of sustained fire until it needs to be replenished with fuel. And not only will you take damage by being directly in the path of the flamethrower, but burning items around its path will also inflict damage. Fortunately, only the level 10 support for the US and German factions will get the flamethrower. This was a relief for me personally, as I didn't want everybody and their mom running around lighting people up. Now there's going to be two different models of flamethrower. The left-hand unit is the US M2-2 flamethrower, and the right unit is the German Flammenwerfer 41. Now the Soviets will not be getting a flamethrower, however, they will get Molotovs. Molotovs were cheap and popular, being used in most battles on the front lines, and therefore the Soviets will have greater access to this weapon than the US and Germans will to the flamethrower. Molotovs are available to Soviet support role at level 6 and assault role at level 9. And I think this is a fair balance, as I think Molotovs are going to be less effective than a flamethrower. The Molotov, when used correctly, will have your foes running in fear. A single direct hit on enemy troops will easily add to the thrower's kill count, alongside setting the immediate area alight. One thing I'm curious about is if the fire damage only applies to that of the flamethrower and the Molotov, or if all fire now in the game on burning tank wrecks and the like will cause damage. I suppose we'll find out in the upcoming playtest, which I'll get to shortly. The developers have also introduced an initial implementation of new uniform texturing to reflect characters being hit by these weapons. Yep, it's just what it sounds like, burnt and bloody uniforms. So ground environments, vehicles, and even bodies will burn for a time after being hit with the flame weapons. But guys, that's not all that's new with update 13. The developers have also announced the implementation of the highly anticipated Jeep, the US with the Willys, Axis with the Kubelwagen, and the Soviets with the Gaz-67. The Jeeps will also offer a limited ammunition resupply for troops on the ground, similar to how supply truck drops work. These vehicles can drop two ammo boxes before requiring a return to base resupply. The ammo box functions similar to the ammo crates dropped by the commander, although they're done in smaller quantities, allowing only 6 resupplies. And if you're not really familiar with how the commander's ammo drop works, go ahead and check out my Ultimate Commander guide, where I cover all the commander abilities in great detail. But guys, we're not done there. We're also getting the ability to set cosmetic presets. Now, when accessing the loadout screen, players will be greeted with a preset number 1 and preset number 2 option below the Appearance tab. Switching between presets will remember your last configured cosmetic for that preset, which allows players to, for example, create a preset wearing snow camouflage that can be easily switched to when moving from a lush green environment to a snowy one. This should help alleviate some people's concerns about people running around with winter uniforms on Omaha Beach. However, not everybody's going to use this feature, so we're definitely going to see some goofy uniforms running around on maps that don't make any sense for that uniform. But at this point, it's a step in the right direction. If you're interested in getting a sneak peek at all these updates, you might want to participate in the playtest. A great place to stay up to date on when the playtest will take place is the official Hell Let Loose Discord, or you can join my Discord at discord.gg/soulsniper, and I'll keep you posted as well. So we've got the new map Kharkov, winter base uniforms for all factions, flamethrowers, Molotovs,
whips, chains, whistles, yo-yos,
drivable jeeps, the Soviet T-70 light tank, appearance loadout option for uniforms, various quality of life items, which are always great and I'm really curious to hear more about, and a host of other gameplay improvements and fixes. I'm looking forward to getting my hands on the full patch notes, and most of all, I'm looking forward to tearing it up in-game with you guys. Have a good one.